Well, it's almost sunset again, but it is still summer. Today is the 24th of June, Sunday, the 24th of June. Yes, the 24th day of June, the fifth day of summer, the sixth day of the moon, in the 55th year of the space age. The space age began on the 12th day of autumn in the year 1957, according to what we still call years, the common era or the year of our Lord Jesus Christ, 1957 AD or CE. Anno Domini, the year of the Lord. 1957, on October the, was it the 7th or the 3rd? I believe it was the 3rd, because it was the 12th day of autumn. And in order to be the 12th day, it couldn't have been the 7th of October. It was 1957. October 3rd, 1957, which was the 12th day of autumn that year. And by coincidence, it was also the 12th day of the moon. So the space age began with the first human that we know of, the first known human satellite to orbit the Earth, to do more than fly up and fall back down. The famous, as we call it in English, Sputnik, or as it's pronounced in Spanish, Sputnik, and I believe in Russian it's pronounced Sputnik. The famous Sputnik was launched on October 3rd, 1957, and began the space age. I spent a number of months contemplating what to start, what date to pick for the start of the calendar I decided I was going to invent. This was back in 1995. In 1996, I was thinking of writing for the internet, but I didn't like the calendars. I wanted to have my own calendar so the people wouldn't even know what day it was, because no one would bother to learn my calendar. But at the same time, while I wanted a calendar that no one would know what day it was, I also wanted it to be realistic. So I thought of the electric age, but then I didn't know whether to start it with Benjamin Franklin playing with lightning or Thomas Edison and the light bulb. I thought of the atomic age, which would have begun with the first nuclear reaction, but I found that rather negative and destructive and kind of a bummer, actually, the incineration of people in order to destroy their ability to make war. So I finally realized that what I wanted, I had another thought before I settled on space age. I thought, well, I'll start it on my birthday. It's my calendar. Be my birthday. But I thought, no, it has to be something that everyone can understand, that everyone can agree, yes, that was a change in history. That was something that before that, things were different, and after that, things were different. Somebody's knocking over there. Knock, knock, knock. So I finally realized that the space age was exactly what I was looking for, and it didn't hurt that it was only a few days before my birthday, which is at the beginning of October. Octo Ocho, in fact. So I decided I would begin the calendar on October 7th, 1957, but I had already decided that my calendar would be revolving not around names of months, which aren't even a moon long, but would actually be tied in with the real seasons. Now, the only problem with tying the calendar in with the real seasons is that at the northern solstice, which we have just passed by, summer begins in the north hemisphere, but winter begins in the southern hemisphere. Whereas at the southern solstice, summer begins in the southern hemisphere, but winter begins in the northern hemisphere. So saying winter and summer only is appropriate for half the planet. And in a way, it's not really appropriate even for the equator, the tropics, because they are a completely separate realm, climatologically speaking, where the questions of the sun being to the north or the south are not as important as altitude above sea level. So that the great Andes Mountains in the country of Ecuador on the equator are thousands of feet above sea level and are covered with snow and ice that sometimes never melts at all because they're so far above into the air sticking up. For indeed, as you go up in elevation in the mountains, it's like moving towards the north or the south pole, climate-wise. But since I was making a calendar for myself, I decided, well, I'll work on the solstice problem later and continue to refer to it as summer and winter by the northern hemisphere standards, which is entirely ethnocentric of me, northocentric. Never mind that the majority of humans live in the northern hemisphere and the minority live in the southern hemisphere, just the same. One major English-speaking nation, Australia, lives in the south, and the nations at the southern end of Africa, which also speak English, live in the south. And since I not only speak English, but I speak Spanish quite fluently, those are in my mind when I think of culture and civilization. I quite naturally think not just of English, but of Spanish, my other beloved language. And there we have Argentina and Chile and so many countries in South America. And even at a stretch, Brazil, which speaks Portuguese. So there are, in fact, millions upon millions of people who live in the south of the planet, and for whom summer does not come in June, but in December. So, in spite of that, I continue, and still continue, on my website, Tijuana Gringo, to measure the days by the moons and the seasons. And so for me, in Tijuana and in San Diego, in California and in Baja California, today is the fifth day of summer, the sixth day of the moon, and there's the moon right up there. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 6 days of the moon. and the solstice fell upon the 20th of June, 2021, 22, 23, 24, the fifth day after the northern solstice, or here in the northern hemisphere, the fifth day of summer. Yet my mind leaps to Argentina and Chile and Australia and South Africa, where it is, in fact, the fifth day of winter. So, that's how I came to say today is the sixth day of the moon and the fifth day of the northern summer. I cannot give up my old patterns, however. So when I think of the date, I almost always think first the day of the week. Today is Sunday. I know what day it is. The day of the week comes to mind even before the date, 24th of June. I am out here chatting again on the sunset time, it being this lovely moment of sunset here above Freeway Valley, which you can hear roaring in the background beyond my muttering. And you can see it down there, Freeway Valley, the cars rushing, and also reflected in the glass skin of that Freeway Valley office complex. And there is the Great Freeway Valley Freeway Bridge, which leads, in the summer, leads to the sun set. The sun is significantly to the north of the Freeway Valley Towers, and there he is. We have not had as intense a set of coastal clouds today. In fact, below that cloud, it appears to be clear air, and you can see the silhouette of Mount Soledad with its radio towers out there. My hand is starting to shake now at this extreme zoomed in position. Mount Soledad, and there's the edge of it dropping off, is a hill near La Jolla. In fact, La Jolla is just behind that hill. That's about 12 miles in the west of here. We are here about 12 miles from the sea. Compared with 93 million miles to that great ball of gas that appears to be sinking through the clouds. The sun will, I believe, be seen setting behind Mount Soledad tonight, something which I have not seen for quite some time. I've been putting so much ice in my drink, it's practically all water, which is just as well. I'm trying not to drink quite so much. I haven't eaten dinner. Oh, damn, I've lost the focus of the sun. Too bad. There we go. There's a electric substation over there on the north side of Freeway Valley. There's some more of the towers there. It's a rather hefty little complex, actually. It serves much of the central part of the city of San Diego. You can see the sun is sinking behind the second arm of cloud and proceeding to enlighten the bottom of the deck of cloud. The effect of sunset is really quite spectacular. We so far have had a number of ordinary sunsets. I really wouldn't know how to film an extraordinary sunset because it occupies the entire sky and there's a high deck of clouds and they're all painted underneath by the setting sunlight shining in beneath them. That's when you get the really spectacular effects. And now we can see the sun is completely masked by the intervening deck of clouds, and it is about to burst out below, I believe, and make its final descent behind the hills that we call Mount Soledad, which is, as I said, just before La Jolla. The effect of sunlight in the clouds is really quite lovely. Makes me want to get a more powerful camera just to capture some of the extraordinary lighting which results from masked sunlight and the walls of water vapor. Here it comes, the limb of the sun emerging from behind the bottom of the cloud deck as it makes its last descent toward the hills. I am hoping that I won't kill my poor little camera by shooting so much of the sun. It is quite a temptation. I'm not certain whether or not I have caused any grievous harm. I would have to compare images from a few weeks ago with those I am now shooting, but for the moment I'm going to spare the lens and wait until the sun has descended a little bit. I suppose it wouldn't hurt to point out some of the neighbors' houses with the sun shining off the window there. it lights up the walls of our house. Ah, there it is. Right in the door, you see? Caught in the door of our house. And in the neighbor's sliding door, as their plants cast shadow upon the wall, waving in the breeze. There's a bit of a breeze here. As is as usual, it's starting to get chilly. We're so close to the ocean here, and the ocean is so cool. Actually, quite cold. This is not a warm ocean. The California Current is not like the Gulf Stream. The California Current comes from the north, from the Arctic, and sweeps cold water down the coast of California toward Mexico before turning out into the ocean in the great circular gyre of water. Yes, we see now the sun has touched the horizon and is sinking behind the earth. This is that moment. The great crack between the worlds. When the sky holds less and less of the sun, and the earth covers more and more of it. Slow is the sun's name. Steady is the sun's name. Constant is the sun's name. The sun's name is alive. Now, on the screen, it looks like there's green, but in real life, I don't see any green. I believe that's a telltale effect of me burning my poor little camera's robot eye. Stunning crimson and gold and orange. Really. There. Strange green flashing. I wonder if that would show in reality. Well, thank you again for putting up with me babbling during the sunset. I will endeavor to return from time to time. From California, I bid you Good night, and God bless.